Godot development is really fast, with tons of exciting new features improving the engine even more. So let's check out what's new, what's changed, and what's in the future of Godot. The first big change we have is the new default theme look. Now it is more compact and have more neutral colors. This is actually an important change, because the previous blue color theme was affecting how games color graded their scenes. Now that is not a problem anymore. But besides that, now we finally have a replacement for the old skeleton and keynote that uses the new bone modifier system. It is even more robust and can be adjusted for several situations. You can now safely use them to make procedural animations or to adjust poses to fine-tune animations to any situation you want. But even more than that, we got the new chain IK modifiers, and now three variations of it too, including fabric, that can give you a very fluid worm-like movement that is very fun to play around with. Besides these important changes, we also got a lot of useful new features for the editor. Tired of creating collisions by hand? Now you can create primitive collision shapes automatically with the mesh menu. Just select primitive, and Godot will detect the basic shape that better fits the mesh. And there is now a much easier way to tell if a resource is unique. If multiple instances of a resource is used, you'll now see this link icon beside it, and you can simply click it to create a unique copy of the resource there. The rotation gizmos has been changed to display how much rotation you are applying now. And you can now hold Alt while moving the camera to snap it at 45 degree angles. Multi-line labels will now auto-scroll when dragging the selection, making it much easier to select bigger texts. Going to the script editor for a bit, the Finding Files window now lists how many things has been found. And using the Replace option, you can now individually apply only selected changes to the files, either by using the checkboxes or with the icon on the right, including the one for the whole file. Scripts will now auto-open when you create them from the file dock, removing the extra step. Now, you might know that you can drop nodes while holding Ctrl to create an on-ready var, but now you can hold Alt instead to create export variables with their references already set up for you. The export range decorator can now use the preferred slider option that will give you a slider even with int variables. And 2D draw have new additions with the new draw ellipses functions, making it much easier to create more complex shapes. But even the project manager got some upgrades. You can now change the editor settings without opening a project, move selections with the arrow keys, and even right-click projects now for some quick extra options, such as renaming the project or opening them in recovery mode. But we are not done yet. The game window got some updates too. You can now directly change the game speed from the top bar, reducing or even speeding up the game. But this is not the same as changing the physics timescale. It will directly affect the FPS of the running game, so you can analyze and identify possible bugs with your game. And speaking of bugs, we now have a really powerful new debug tool, the ObjectDB Profiler. Using this, you can take snapshots of your currently loaded objects and precisely analyze what is happening with your game at a time, which is a great way to find bugs or performance issues. You can even take other snapshots and compare the difference between the two and try to find what went wrong and what's changed. And speaking of big changes, you can now choose to use custom navigation engines for both 3D and 2D navigation meshes. This doesn't do anything by itself, but it means now Godot have a system in place to allow new custom navigation algorithms to be added via GD extensions. Then we also got a few minor changes. DPI textures now have a nice preview where you can see the final generated texture. And margin containers now displays a gizmo showing where the margins start to help create UIs. And for mobile, you can now set a path to SCR copy to allow your Android deploy to also show its screen on your PC. The file dock now has new shortcut actions you can add. You can now create files, scripts, and resources using shortcuts there, which is a much welcome addition while creating resource-based games where a lot of resources are needed. Inline arrays are much more compact, with their button orders and positions changed in a way that makes much more sense now. Then we also got better LOD generation. LODs will now keep details much better even if they are small separate meshes. And there is now a new selection mode, where you can only select objects without all the gizmos showing up. The old mode is now called transformation mode, and can be accessed at the top, or through the V hotkey. And just to take a peek of the future, here are some of the upcoming features that may or may not come to Godot 4.6. First, we have 2D CSG operations stated to come to 4.6, making it possible to merge and make holes in 2D meshes. Then we have the option to add nearest filtering to subviewports, which is great if you want to quickly add that old style look. This one has been a long time coming, but now it seems all the problems are mostly solved, and it might just be coming to 4.6. And here we got one of my most anticipated features, applying changes to editable children. No more going back and forth into scenes to make small changes. But although this is planned for 4.6, there are still a lot of problems to solve, so it's still unsure if we'll get this in time. We also got better preview meshes for materials. And although this is not planned for 4.6, this feature request has been mostly approved, so there is a good chance we'll be seeing it soon. And let's not forget the thumbnail generation for 3D assets that got pulled out of 4.5 beta. The updated feature is still alive and work is being done to it. But that's it, a lot has been done, and there is a lot of awesome new features coming to Godot. With the more modernized look and tons of usability additions, Godot will surely feel a lot different. I hope you can continue to make good games with it, and until next time.